did some small other photo etch work, being these two brackets. I think they represent an antenna bracket. Not really clearly shown in the instructions how you should bend them, but well, with a bit of fiddling around, it fell together, so no problems there. Next up in the instructions are these small guys, one on each side. I think the camera can show it like this, which is the headlamp array, side by side, two of them, and one on the left and one on the right side, and I'll have to figure out where they go. Okay, there they are. They should sit in these small recesses. Again, confusing. Why would you make the slot 1.5 times as wide as these lamps? I still find these things confusing, and I think if the kit manufacturers can make it with CAD CAM and all the other digital users they have, then surely it must be possible to make the slot just as wide as the lamps that should go in there. Anyway, our hobby always is a bit of a puzzle, so I think I'll just be sensible about it and put it in the middle. I think that will be best. Looking for the other one. Some time ago, just thinking of something I would like to show you guys. These clippers, sprue cutters, whichever you call them, are made by a company called Azuron. I don't know if the brand name will show up on the computer. Gilbert from Red Dragon Motherworks already did a small review on the tools he uses. Well, these are mine. This pair, very old, still works great. I know Gilbert likes the Tamiya ones, but I have never seen these in Holland. So these ones have been bought by me through Micromark in America. I don't recall the exact amount, but they were very expensive. Some time ago, while doing my weekly survey on the eBay, I found these guys. Cheapest chips, as the British say. They, I think I paid somewhere in the region of, I think, 3 or 4 euros. On another site I saw these guys, which are in fact the same. Only thing is the spring on this one is also painted black. I know these don't come near the quality of the Zuron pliers, but for the money the Zuron costs, I can buy, I think, at least 10 of these. If I recall it right, I paid 45 euros for the Zuron one in Holland, because I had to import it, of course. Only downside, and then I'll show the green one again, is that these clipper ends are very thick, and you destroy small parts with it instantaneously. So what I did, and which I had already done on the red one, and I'm gonna do on the green one as well, is to grind them down just with I have a rotating sander. Does the camera show it clearly? Let's see. I'll hold a piece of black material behind it. That will be better. And as you can see, I thinned them down considerably. I was a bit too enthusiastic, and I thinned them down even beyond the range of the Zuron. And hey presto, a new trick was born, because with these cheap as chip clippers, I can now cut out even the smallest, tiniest, fragile part from the sprue. So there goes an idea. For all you guys out there looking for a cheap sprue cutter, just buy these ones on eBay. There is a brand name on the green one which says Linbon. I'm not sure if you can look or if you can sort it out by brand, but they work very well. I'm very very happy with these. Okay, on with the YPR. Looking for the second hand headlight array, so I can put it on the other side. Let's look up. It's part C42. Being this one. On the detail side, I don't think the fit is 100%, and I'm, as said, not a real armor modeler, so I don't know how the normal kits of AFE are. I've done some Tamiya kits in previous years. They do fit, but true is the older Tamiya kits are not that great as well. And again, in all fairness, a new Tamiya kit, as I look through all the videos that you guys make on the YouTube channel, are not all the best of fitting as well. So it's not all in the big brand names. No, I don't think they do an outstanding job, or at least not always. Detail-wise, they are very, very, very nice. I'll have to give them that. This kit is exceptionally well detailed. Being from Holland, where this one also originates as a real item, the YPR 765. I have never seen one in real life, so I don't know what the real item looks like, and I think for the majority of our plastic model building hobby, as soon as you see the real item, you fall in love with it and you want to build it yourself. So, or at least that's my experience on Airplane. That is an annual show in Leeuwarden, quite nearby where I live, which is held every other year. So these two guys are on now. 1 year it's in Leeuwarden, the other year is in Volkel, more to the bottom side of Holland. Always when I attend these shows, I see the aircraft for real on display, or the flying items. And I have never ever had one day I came home and didn't want to build something that I saw that day. 2 years ago, or was it a year ago, I'm not sure, I saw the Fuga Magister. Perhaps you aircraft guys know it is the old jet airplane, French airplane, which has the tail planes arranged as a V shape. It's as ugly as hell. I have to give it that. But I came home and I immediately wanted to build one. And of course, as always, there isn't the kit available of that aircraft. So I had to look through the internet. I finally found one. And to be honest, in the meantime, when I was looking, I fell in love with another aircraft. So the Fuga is on the still to-do pile, which is, as all you guys would recognize, ever increasing, increasing, and still increasing. is another video on the progress I did on my YPR 765 for the Grim Jim C and Mark O'Neill group build. I saw some progress on all the other guys who participate. Looking mighty nice. Work is all progressing nicely. I saw some work on Koen, his build. I saw some work from Nigel. Looking very good. This is how far I got today. I'll take off the gun. And then I'll start showing you all the details I added on the main hull. There's also a little small photo edge detail plate over here, which should be glued on. I don't know what it's called, but I think it would be some kind of guard, or perhaps this is a footrest. Or other thing could be that it mounts this item when in real life this flips over, and then perhaps this mounts on the street or whatever. The flare or smoke discharges are glued on, a small filler cap over here, some towing eyes or towing down hooks, the front hatch, grab handles, oh hold on, I'll let the camera focus on it, some grab handles over here, antenna, feet, some tools, and piece of spare track. These are handles for the tools. This is the handle for the picket. There is also a small sledgehammer included. On the other side again, the grab handles, filler cap, and a guard for over the filler cap. On every corner of the vehicle there is a small signal light, which should be painted orange. On the backside, there is I thought it was a fuel canister, but it clearly states water. So I think the Dutch are more thirsty than their vehicle, because there are no gas cans included. It's mounted in a small photo edge bracket and tied down by a small photo edge belt. Okay. Also on the front, where the gun is mounted, there are a couple of small pieces added. Of course this hatch, this little box, whatever it may be, has been added. And a little grab handle on the front. Yesterday evening I was looking through some YouTube films, movies, videos, on the real thing, on the YPR 765. There are a couple of nice ones. One in particular was very handy, because a guy is invited to make sort of a test drive with such a machine. Only thing I could find different on this one and the real one was that the Dutch had some wire racks on the sides. I suppose they were used for stowage. These are not included on this kit, but for the rest, yeah, it was looking very convincing. So gives me a bit of confidence in this one, being able to build a nice replica with it. Okay, after the initial build on the hull, I still have to do a couple of little items and then it will be done. I had to start work on the gun, the turret and the gun itself. Yeah, well, it is a bit of a kit in itself. It consists of quite some parts. As you can imagine, the gun is separate, and I hope the camera picks it up. As you can see, I drilled out the gun nozzle. It can rotate freely up and down elevation. There is a small box mounted on the top. I suppose they are sensors, and this must be the periscope where the gunner can look through. For the rest, the sides consist of three or four parts. There is a back plate, which is a separate item, a bottom, a top, and then a gun with the rotating pieces is I think six or seven separate items. So they look very nice. On these hatches, I saw on the video I just mentioned that the Dutch have another cover over it, and that must be a dust cover or a, what's it called, FOD cover. These covers are included in the kit, and I'm not sure if they were always used or just used when the machine is not operating or whatever. But I'll have to figure out if I'm gonna add those, and then I'll can easily glue them on in a later state. Fit-wise, I'm very satisfied with it. The kit is good, fit of parts is good, and as I said earlier in my first video, only downside, as far as I can be the judge of it, are the instruction sheets. And I'll try and explain some. I'm not all that common to military vehicles, so could be just me not knowing or not clever enough to figure it out. But as you can see in this diagram, all parts are shown as separate items, which of course is as always, as everybody does. But then look at just the small items, and there is only an arrow pointing down saying it should go on the hull, which gives me a real duh moment. Of course it should go down on the hull, but where should it go down on the hull? There are separate hole or separate, there are several holes in the hull. You can fit it anywhere, so which is the right position? And then they try and clarify it a little bit with a top view, but this is the only top view included in the whole instruction sheet, and well, I think they haven't done a mighty good job on it. Same goes for this, for the small photo etch plate. Where should it go? There is nowhere. There is a small area painted gray or colored gray, and stick it over there. But should it go to the left? Should it go to the right? I don't know. You just have to figure it out. Same goes for these two items. There is not an indication on where these items should go. So I think for a kit this expensive, lucky me that I could buy it as a used item or as a second hand kit. But I can imagine if you pay $40 or $50, €40 or €50, whatever, for it, then I can imagine you'd be disappointed with the instruction sheet. And the kit in itself, apart from all the fiddly tiny little items, even a novice builder could build it, because the fit is very good, apart from one or two things which need a bit squeezing. But anyway, you could put it all together very nicely. And only downside would be then, as I said, the instructions, because you really need a bit better guidance on where items should go. So well, I'm quite satisfied with it. I'll get cracking on. I'll have to glue and fit some last pieces, and then I'm ready for a paint job. So I think my third video will be for the painting. So until the next video, have fun and good luck with your builds.